Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be presenting before you a live demonstration of an advanced and ready-to-go Uber-like taxi booking and ride-sharing solution, GoCab. It's a complete Uber-like taxi booking tech solution that includes branded customer booking app and website, easy-to-use driver app, the taxi dispatch software, and the admin app. So before we begin, if you are planning to launch your own branded taxi application like Uber, Lyft, or Careem, do sign up on our website to get free consultations from top industry experts. So let's start with the demo now. As you can see, this is the admin panel, and we're going to start with the dashboard first. So in the dashboard, you can get the 360 view of the entire application. You can see everything from the pending orders to the return requests. Once you scroll down, you can see the data in a graphical representation of revenue and sales, and you can filter it by the date. Once you scroll down further, you can see the revenue generated by the location and the bookings that have been in the top category. So next we have the orders. So here is the list of the pending bookings, the active bookings, and the history of the bookings. So once the admin confirms or rejects a certain booking, that particular booking will move on to the active, and once it's completed, it will move on to the orders, order history. So we also provide you with the return request option, where you can see the return request made by the customers. Next, we have the vendors. Here is the list of the active vendors, the vendors that currently need approval, or the vendors that have been blocked by the admin. In case you want to see more information regarding a particular vendor, you can do so by clicking on the name. Once you do that, you can see all the information that you need, the total services that particular vendor is dealing in, the published services, you can choose a commission, and so on. And in case you want to add a new vendor to the list, you can do so by clicking on the add button here, filling in the details, and once you click on submit, then that particular vendor will be added. So let's move on to the accounting section. First, we have orders. Here is the entire transaction history of the orders placed. So you can see the total order value, the total number of orders, the total cash to be collected, and the total delivery fees. So in case you want a more detailed report of any particular order, you just click on the order ID here, and then that particular information will be displayed here. It's the same for the loyalty cards, the promo codes, the taxes, and the vendors. So in vendors, you can basically see the total ad order value, the total delivery fees, and the total admin commission. Moving on to the payout request, any payout request made by the vendor will be displayed here. So in case the admin owes any particular vendor some amount of money, then that particular request will be displayed here, and the admin can choose an action in case he wants to pay the vendor directly, or if he wants to reject that particular request, he can do so by choosing an action here. Once he does that, it will move on to the completed section. Moving on to the customer section, here we have the list of the entire customers that have used or have been using this application. So you can see the active user account, the inactive user account, and the social login account. And in case you want to grant a particular customer with certain permissions, you can do so by clicking on the name, and you can grant you certain permissions to any particular vendor. Once you do that, just click on submit, and that particular customer will be updated with those permissions as well. And in case you want to add a new customer, you can do so by clicking on the add option here, filling in the details, clicking on submit, and then that particular customer will be added. So in product reviews, you can basically see the reviews and the comments that have been made by the customers or the users. Moving on to the settings, first we have profile. So you can change the profile of your company, you can upload your logo, you can choose a name, you can fill in the email, the company address, and so on. Once you click on update, all this information will be updated, and it will be displayed on the user application and the web application as well. Moving on to the customize section. Here you can choose between the light and the dark theme. You can choose a date format, the time format. You can choose a primary language for the application, the primary currency that the application is going to be dealing in. You can add a custom domain address, social media, and you can choose terminology of various things as well. In case you want to change the vendors to the merchants, You can do so by typing in merchant here. Once you do that, click on save. Once it's done, you can see the vendors change to the merchants. So for now, we're going to change it back to the vendors. Next, we have styling. Under styling, we have two options, that is app styling and the website. So what styling does is it changes the appearance of the application, the user application and the web application as well. So you can choose between various font styles, you can pick a color, the tab bar style, you can upload tutorials, and you can choose a home page. Similarly, for the web styling, the only difference being that all these customizations will be made in the user website instead of the mobile application. So next we have CMS. Under CMS, first we have pages. So you can use this section to add a new page, like the terms and conditions, the privacy policies, or the FAQ. So in case I want to add a new page like FAQ, I will click on add. I will fit the details, the title, that is going to be FAQ, the rest of the details. Once I click on add, in that particular frequently asked question pages will be added to the user application as well. Moving on to the email section. Here we have certain templates set for the email. So in case a new vendor signs up, so he or she will receive this particular email, and the admin has the option to customize the email as per his own requirement. So this is what the email section is for. Moving on to the notifications. So notification is a section that the admin can use to send notification to the vendor, the customer, or the driver. So in case a new an order is accepted or a booking has been successful, so the customer will receive this particular notification saying that his or her booking was successful. So the admin can customize this notification as per their own requirements. Once you click on publish, then those changes will be made. Moving on to the catalog. Here we have the list of all the categories that the admins or the applications are going to be dealing in. So here we have the cab service, the motor service, the auto service, and in case you want to add a new category, you can do so by clicking on the add option here, filling in the details. Once you click on submit, then that particular category will be added. And in case you want to add a subcategory to it, choose a parent category. Once you do that, that particular subcategory will be added to its parent category, which will be the category in itself. Next, we have the configuration. So the admin can choose if he's going to be offering pickup and delivery, infinite social logins. He can add a third-party API like Google Maps and so on. Can add SMS, API, and so on. So this is what the configuration section does. You can basically integrate the third-party API, and you can also choose between pickup and delivery service. So let's move on to the taxes. So here you can add a particular tax category, for example, VAT. And in India we have GST, so you can add that as well. In case I want to add a new tax category, I will do so by clicking on the add option, filling in the title, the code, the description. Once I click on submit, then that particular tax category will be added. And in case I want to choose a tax rate for that, I can do so by clicking on the add option here, choosing the category which we first made. So in this example, it's going to be VAT. I can choose the identifier and I can fill in the tax rate. Let's take, for example, 10%. Once I click on submit. So now this tax rate has been added to the tax category VAT. Next, we have payment option. So the payment options are the options that the admin can provide to the customer. So payment options like cash on delivery, PayPal, Stripe, and other payment options can also be provided to the customer. Once you click on save, all these payment options will be updated on the user application. Moving on to the marketing, which is the most interesting part of this admin panel. So first we have banners. So banner is a marketing tool, you know, which can redirect a customer. Once he clicks on the banner, he will be redirected to that particular vendor or to that particular service. So it can be used as a marketing tool to publicize a new product, a new service, or a new vendor. So it's pretty simple to add a new banner. You just have to click on the add option here. Once you do that, you fill in the name of the banner, when it's going to start and when it's going to end, whom you're going to assign it to, if it's going to be assigned to a category or the vendor, the name. Once you do that, you click on submit, and that particular banner will be added and it will be displayed on the user application as well. So next we have promo codes. So promo codes are the benefits that the admin offers to their customer. So the customers can avail these promo codes to get a certain discount. It's pretty simple to add a promo code. You just have to click on the add option here. Once you do that, fill in the details like the title, the short description, what the promo code is going to be, who the bearer of the promo code is going to be, if it's going to be the admin or the vendor, what the promo code is going to be on the minimum amount, what the maximum amount is going to be, the limit per user, the total limit, the restriction type, and the promo visibility, if it's going to be public or if it's going to be private. Click on submit, that particular promo code will be added. Lastly, we have the loyalty cards. So loyalty cards are the benefits that a customer can avail after they gather a certain point. So every time a customer uses the application for any service like the cab booking, so he or she will receive certain points, and after a point, once they accumulate enough points to avail any particular loyalty card, they can avail it and use it to their advantage. So they can, you know, avail discounts. The admin has the option to choose points for every rupee, and in case you want to add a new loyalty card, you can do so by clicking on the add option here, filling in the details. Once you do that, click on the submit, then that particular loyalty card will be added. So this is what the admin panel is used for. So now I'm going to place a booking for cab service so you can better understand the flow of the application.
So this is the GoCab user app where you can book a ride. Now as you can see, we have three panels here: home, rides, and accounts. So in the home section, you can choose from various options like cab service, motor service, or auto service. We also have the option to schedule the ride for the later by clicking on the now option. Once you scroll down, you can see the drivers around you. In the right section, you can basically see the active rides and the past rides, active and past booking. And in the account section, you can basically manage the things like loyalty cards, wallet, and you can add money to your wallet. You can look at the links and the pages like terms and conditions, privacy policies, and so on. You can share the application, you can customize the user application, like choosing between a light or the dark theme. You can attach a printer, or you can contact the support staff using the contact us option. So let's book a service to see the flow of the application. I'm going to choose the cab service. Now I'm going to fill in the pickup and the drop location. Once I do that, I will click on done. Now I can choose from various options like premium, pool, and so on. I'm going to choose premium for now and click on confirm. So now I have the option to choose from various other payment options like cash on delivery or wallet, and I can also apply a promo to coupon to it. So let's book the cab now. The application will now look for drivers based on their location. Now, as you can see, I received the notification for the pickup since I have already logged into the driver app. Now, once I confirm it and start the pickup, I can now navigate to the pickup location. Once I reach the location, I will mark myself as arrived. Then once I'm done dropping the customer, I will press hold to complete the task. And then lastly, I will provide with a proof like a photograph or a signature. So to conclude, once I click on done, to add a signature, I will click on the signature option. I will add a signature now, click on done. So now, once I'm done with the task, it will move on to the all task. So to conclude, this is the flow of the user application of GoCab. If you have any further queries or questions, do comment below or contact us at www.codebrew.com.